release of FileMaker 19, Claris added the ability to create custom add-ons. Custom add-ons allow developers to create content packaged into an add-on, and users can download those add-ons and drag them directly into their FileMaker solutions. We're going to show you how to create the add-on, how to download the add-on, and how to add the add-on into your FileMaker solution. First, we're going to start creating the add-on. You can see here we have the content that we want to be part of our add-on on a layout. We need to make sure that this layout is the default FileMaker template layout for creating add-ons. So to do that, you need to create a layout with this naming convention, __fm_addon_template_directives_en. And it needs to be based on the same context as the content of your add-on. So for us, that's the payment context. So now go to that layout that you just created. And you see here, we've already created our content for payment portal. Once you have all the content that you want created, select it all and add it to a group. This group is what's going to be part of the add-on. Anything that's not in this group will not be part of the add-on. The add-on can reference scripts and other layouts as long as their references are part of this group. Next, we need to set up some of our relationships. To do this, we need to create a foreign key from the context of our content, so from the payment context. Our foreign key is just going to be called parent ID. So this will link to the host file. Once you have that field on the layout, we need to specify the object name. This also follows a very specific naming convention. What we need to do is name this the same as whatever relationship we need to use. So we're going to name it parent, payment, parent ID. Next, a vertical column. And then you need to tell it what side it needs to be on right. So this is going to be a right table. Once that's done, you need to highlight the field that you just named, as well as something else to arrange it into a group. We recommend the name of the field. Group that, and then you need to name this group as well. This also follows a naming convention. __FMAddon_dynamic_relation_, and then the name of your relationship. This field and label will not be part of the add-on when they drag this onto their screen. Next, we're going to create a button that allows us to save the add-on. This is a simple button. It performs a single step, and that step is save a copy as add-on package. It takes in a parameter of the window name, and we want it to replace UUID, so it creates a new package every time. This button also will not be included as part of the content that gets dragged onto the screen because it is not grouped in with our main content. Once that's done, we can save the add-on. It'll pull up a browser window that shows you the location of your add-on. So creating the add-on is done. We can now show you how to download the add-on. So to do this, we're going to create a new file using the contact template. All right, so to download and install the add-on, go into layout mode, add-on, and then add, and then find the add-on. Your add-on will be by default named the same as the file in which it was created. Your add-on is now installed. All we need to do is create a place to put the content. and drag it over. As you can see, the payment record is now tied to the contact based on our relationship. This allows you to easily and quickly add content that has been packaged into an add-on into your FileMaker solution. If you need more help or assistance adding add-ons into your FileMaker solution, feel free to reach out and contact us.